that Ramadan was the beginning of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the Quran in the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be the final messenger in the month of Ramadan. So Ramadan is the beginning of Islam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we all knew, he used to stay during the month of Ramadan to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the cave of Hira, when Allah azza wa jal sent Angel Jibreel to him for the first time to order him to read. Iqra', Iqra' bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Read. Read by the name of your Lord who created. So the first verse of Quran came down from the preserved tablet to Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam was in the month of Ramadan. So Ramadan is the beginning of our history, the beginning of our religion, the beginning of the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we all knew that Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam lived 13 years in Mecca, leading a minority of Muslims. They faced all types of brutality, all types of transgression, until the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Mecca to Medina, until he established the first Muslim state. The wrongdoers of Quraysh, the transgressors of Quraysh, went behind him. It was not enough for them to kill some believers and to torture some of them and to abuse them. It was not enough for them to kick them out of their land. They went behind them to their new Muslim state, Al-Madinah. So it was the first confrontation between Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Quraysh in the month of Ramadan. The Battle of Badr was on 17th of Ramadan, year number 2 from the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Quraysh came under the leadership of Abu Sufyan. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asking the companions their opinions. He was asking the people their opinions and told them, Ashiru alayya ayyuhan nas. Give me your opinion, O people. I want to hear from you. So Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu stood up and he spoke, supported the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Umar radiallahu anhu stood up and supported the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam with a speech. And it was narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari and narrated by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud that al-Miqdad ibn al-Aswad, he is also one of the leaders of the immigrants, one of the leaders of al-Muhajirin, he stood up and said, O Messenger of Allah, we will not say to you what the children of Israel said to Musa alayhi salam. Go you and your Lord and fight. We are staying here. We will say to you, go you and your Lord. We will fight with you. لن نقول لك كما قالت بنو إسرائيل لموسى اذهب أنت وربك فقاتلا إنها هنا قاعدون بل سنقول اذهب أنت وربك فقاتلا إن معكما مقاتلون. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam heard from the leaders of the immigrants, from the leaders of the people of Mecca, but he still want to hear from the people of Medina, because the people of Medina gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam their covenant to support him alayhi salatu wasalam and to protect him inside the city of Medina. Now the Prophet ﷺ is asking them to come out with him, outside the border of Medina. So he wanted to hear from them. So Imam Muslim reported a narration from Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. Anas narrated and said that Sa'd ibn Ubadah, the leader of Al-Ansar, said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَعَلَّكَ تُرِيدُنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. It looks like you are waiting for our opinion, O Messenger of Allah. So the Prophet said yes. So Sa'd ibn Ubadah said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, والله لو خضت بنا هذا البحر لخضناه معك ما تخلف منا رجل واحد. By Allah, if you will cross the sea, we will cross it with you. None of us will stay back. All of us will be with you. لو سرت بنا إلى برك الغماد لسرنا معك. If you will go and take us to Barak al-Ghamad, which a place so far from Medina, we will go with you in the heart of the desert. And then he said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, صل حبال من شئت وقطع حبال من شئت. Establish a relationship with anyone you want and cut off anyone you want. He said, خذ من أموالنا ما شئت وأعطنا ما شئت. Take from our money whatever you want and give us whatever you want. وما أخذت منا أحب إلينا مما أعطيتنا. And what you take from us is more beloved to us than what you give us. So when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saw the submission of the people of Mecca and the submission of the people of Medina, all of them standing behind their Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, obeying him, he knows that they will be victorious. Because once you submit to the will of Allah, once you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you taste the sweetness of victory. Because the defeat comes only to the disobedient. The defeat reaches always the disobedience. But when the Muslims are obedient, submitting to Allah's will, following their Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they will be victorious. That's why the Muslims were victorious in the day of Badr, in the first confrontation ever between Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the believers and the tyrants of Quraysh. You know, when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was fixing the rows of the Muslims, he was saying to them, "Halummu ila jannatin 'arduha as-samawati wal-ard." Halummu ila jannatin, hasten to a paradise in the width of the skies. Its width like the width of the sky. So Umayr ibn al-Hammam radiallahu anhu repeated the statement behind the Prophet and said, عَرْضُهَا السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بَخِمْ بَخِ. And this statement, بَخِمْ بَخِ, the Arab used to say it when they are amazed, when they wonder. So he said, Subhanallah, the Jannah in the size of the skies, بخم بخ. So the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام asked Umayr ibn al-Hammam and said, ما حملك على أن تقول بخم بخ؟ Why did you say بخم بخ, O Umayr? Umayr said, because I want to be one of the people of Jannah. I really want to be one of the people of Jannah. Then he said to himself, if I'm going to wait until I eat all these dates, he has few dates in his hand. He said, if I will wait until I eat all these dates, it is a long life. He threw the dates away and he followed the soldiers of the Muslims to the battlefield to defend the Muslim country, to defend the believers, to defend the Prophet, to defend the religion of Islam against the transgression of the tyrants of Quraysh. You know, also when you read about this foray of Badr, You will hear that a man, his name is Sa'd ibn Khaythamah. This young man, Sa'd ibn Khaythamah, he wanted to go with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His father wanted to go with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But one of them only must go and the other must stay to take care of their kids and the family. So they were making like lottery to see which one of them, to pick one of them to go and one of them to stay. So Sa'd ibn Khaythamah, the son, the young man, won. So he was going to his father, told him, "Yani, offer me the chance. I'm an old man, I don't have many chances. You are still young. You still have chances in your future." So his son Sa'd told him, "لو كانت غير الجنة لآثرتك على نفسي. If it is anything other than al-Jannah, I would give it to you. I will favor you over myself. If it is anything other than al-Jannah, when it comes to Jannah, I do not give it up for anybody, even my own father or my own mother. When it comes to Jannah, I don't favor anyone." So the Muslims today, when they remember the victory of Badr, they need to remember the cause of this victory. The cause of this victory is a strong iman in the heart. The cause of the victory, they're obedient to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Their submission to Allah's will, their commitment to their deen. That's why they were victorious. So it's not only the first confrontation between the Muslims and Quraysh in Ramadan. It was not only the first confrontation, also the final confrontation. The final confrontation, the opening of Mecca, it was also in Ramadan. So Ramadan is coming to remind you that the beginning of Islam is Ramadan. The first victory in the history of Islam in Ramadan. The first confrontation with the tyrants of Badr in Ramadan. And the final confrontation with the tyrants of Badr was in Ramadan, in the opening of Mecca. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came back to his homeland, came back to the blessed village, the sacred land of Mecca, came back with the believers. They were kicked out from Mecca just 8 years before. 8 years. The expedition of the opening of Mecca was in year 8 from the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was kicked out of Mecca with the immigrants, with the believers, he was promised to come back. Allah promised him that he will come back. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam always, he believes in the promise of Allah, that Allah azza wa jal does not break his promise. And only 8 years, the Prophet alayhi wasallam was able to lead those who migrated with him from Mecca to Medina, and those who supported him from the people of Yathrib. He led them back to Mecca, to the land of Tawheed, to the land of monotheism, to the land of Ibrahim alayhi salam, to the land of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the land of the birth of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as human being, the land of the birth of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as prophet, the land of the birth of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a messenger. He came back and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him to taste the sweetness of victory again in Ramadan. So when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered Mecca without any fight, without any confrontation, the Muslims saw Bilal ibn Rabah, the black man of Abyssinia, who used to be a slave, who used to be tortured in Mecca. They saw him on the top of al-Kaaba making the adhan for the salah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya ala al-salah, hayya ala al-falah. People started to hear the adhan from al-Kaaba. Subhanallah. And also the Muslims were able, after long patience, to destroy 360 statues used to be worshipped around Al-Kaaba. So after the opening of Mecca, there is no more idol worshiping in Mecca. No more Hubal. No more Al-Uzza. All these false gods, all these false gods were destroyed because of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the believers. Because of their obedience, because of their submissions. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them victory. And your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was kicked out 8 years ago from his land, is standing victorious. And the leaders of Quraysh are standing in front of him. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, ماذا تظنون أني صانع بكم? What do you think I will do with you? What do you think? So one of them said, أخٌ كريم وابن أخٍ كريم. سهيل بن عمرو. سهيل بن عمرو said, أخٌ كريم. You are an honorable brother. The son of honorable brother. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not retaliate against them. He did not kill any of them صلى الله عليه وسلم. He did not torture any of them عليه الصلاة والسلام. He forgave them and pardoned them صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء. Anyone closes his door upon him is safe. And whoever enters the house of Abu Sufyan is safe. Because Abu Sufyan used to be the president of Mecca before. So the Prophet is giving him a position. Even when he is victorious, the Prophet is still treating him well. The way he did with the captives of Badr. After the confrontation of Badr, the Prophet ﷺ found the 70 leaders from the leaders of Quraysh in his hand. 70 of them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he commanded the companions to share their food with them. The companions said, we used to eat dates only and give them date and bread, because bread was not enough for everyone. So they used to eat dates only and to give the captives the date and the bread, and they did not torture any of them. And the Prophet did same thing with the leaders of Quraysh after the opening of Mecca. He said, go, you are free. Go, you are safe. Close your door upon yourself and nobody will harm you. And if you enter the house of Abu Sufyan, you will be safe. And when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam chose a leader for Mecca, when the Prophet alayhi wasallam chose a new president to Mecca, he chose Itab ibn Usaid, and he is from the family of Abu Sufyan. So he chose a believer who is from the family of Abu Sufyan, from Bani Umayyah, just to cool the heart of the family of Umayyah. See how the Prophet ﷺ used to be a smart leader, how he is dealing politically with these people when they are defeated, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The month of Ramadan is reminding us with this also. And in between the confrontation of Badr and the expedition of the opening of Mecca, there is the incident of the trench. And I know the incident of the trench did happen in the month of Shawwal, month after Ramadan. But the Muslims, while they are fasting, they used to dig the trench during the fasting days of Ramadan. So I want you to imagine the Muslims fasting, very long day, in very hot days in Mecca. You know how tough the weather in Mecca. When it's hot, it's hot. And the Muslims were digging the trench to protect the city of Mecca from the soldiers of Quraysh while they are fasting. And while they are singing, saying the sheed, Wallahi, lawla Allahi mahtadayna. By Allah, it was not because of Allah we will never be guided. ولا تصدقنا ولا صلينا. Without Allah we will never be able to give charity or even pray. They said فأنزل سكينة علينا. Oh Allah, send down tranquility. وثبت الأقدام إن لاقينا. And grant us a steadfastening. If we are confronting our enemies, إن العدا قد بغوا علينا. Our enemies are transgressing against us. وإن أرادوا فتنة أبينا. If they want to turn us from our deen, if they want us to revert from Islam, we will reject. We will reject. And the Prophet ﷺ was reciting the nasheed with them, saying, Abayna, Abayna. So the Islam was spread all over the earth. Do you know that the Muslims came to the leadership of Spain? Spain, in the west of Europe, after 91 years only from the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After 91 years, Musa ibn Nusayr sent the Muslims, 91 Hijri, and for the mission of making Spain a Muslim country. And Tariq ibn Ziyad achieved the goal, achieved the victory in the month of Ramadan, year 92 from the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Muslims lived there for 800 years. There is no country can stay in power for 800 years if this country is not established upon a good values. Justice, fairness, freedom, the real freedom, freedom of being slaves to their own desires, freedom from being slaves to human beings like them, freedom from being slaves to the materials of this world, being only slaves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they stayed in power for 800 years. And also in Ramadan, Yusuf ibn Tashafin was victorious when he led the believers from Morocco in the battle of Al-Zallaqah. It was also in Ramadan, the victory of Yusuf ibn Tashafin. Also the greatest fitna in the history of Islam, the fitna of Tatar. Tatar, if the Crusaders stayed in Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa 91 years, the Tatars stayed 42 years occupying the lands of Islam, occupying Iraq, Sham, Palestine, occupied all this area and lost millions of souls. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saw their repentance and saw their commitment, their eagerness to be free. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them a good leadership. The leadership of Saifuddin Qutuz, who led the Muslims and defeated the Tatar in the battle of Ain Galut. It was also in Ramadan. It was also in Ramadan. And we learn from the history of Islam that when the Muslims are obedient, when the Muslims are submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the Muslims are worshiping their Lord, remembering the purpose of their existence, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never broke his promise to them. They were always victorious. But when the Muslims favored dunya over akhirah, when the Muslims are following their own desires, when the Muslims are disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the Muslims are divided, so the result is known. You will see the defeat of Uhud. You will see the defeat in front of the Crusaders. You will see the defeat in front of the Mongols, the Tatars. When we are not obeying, we lose. When we are not united, we lose. When we don't have a good leadership, righteous leadership, we lose. But when we have a good leadership, when we are obedient, when you are submitting to Allah as well, we taste victory as Allah promised to subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Muslims need to remember that Ramadan is the month of victory and to expect that Allah Azza wa Jal will grant the Muslims a victory when they are fulfilling their promises to Allah. Gaza will not be occupied forever. And the Masjid al-Aqsa will not be occupied forever. It is not forever. Wallahi, we believe that. It is not forever. Until now, 72 years, no problem. The Tatar stayed 42 years and they left. The Crusaders stayed 91 years and they left. And they defeated and left. They were defeated and left. And every ummah occupied the lands of the Muslims. Stayed whatever time they stayed. At the end, once the Muslims wake up, once the Muslims repented to Allah, Allah grants them victory, Azza wa Jal. And I should not forget the victory, even in our era, in the time of weakness, in the time of poverty, in the time of ignorance that we are living in. We tasted victory on the 10th of October, 1973. The land of Sinai in Egypt was occupied by the Zionists. And the Muslims, when they repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they started to shout, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them victory and liberated the land of Sinai. And I believe, once we repented to Allah Azza wa Jal, Palestine will be free. Once we repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the war in Sudan will be stopped. Once we repented to Allah Azza wa Jal, the Muslims in Syria, the Muslims in Libya, the Muslims in Yemen, the Muslims in India, the Muslims in Kashmir will be in good shape, will be protected, will be victorious. Just we need to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. Just we need to correct our belief, to strengthen our faith in Allah Azza wa Jal and His Messenger. We need to submit to Allah's will. We need to stop following our desires. We need to stop favoring the worldly gain over Al-Jannah and Al-Akhirah. And when we do so, we will be victorious. The future is for Islam, no question asked. The point is, do we see that in our lifetime? Think about it. It is not about it will happen or not. It will happen for sure. The Muslims will be united again for sure. The Muslims will become strong again for sure. It is the promise of Allah Azza wa Jalla and His Messenger. I have no doubt about it. The only thing that I may have doubt about it is us. Are we the people who will taste victory, witness victory, enjoy victory in our lifetime, or it will be the coming generations? But it will happen, it will happen. And it may happen in Ramadan. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه سميع قريب. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى أصحابه وأحبابه ومن استنى بسنته واقتفى أثره ودعا بدعوته إلى يوم الدين. My brothers and sisters, let's make the month of Ramadan a month of victory against ourselves. Let's be victorious and win the war against the shaitan. Start from here Start from winning your war against the shaitan who is trying to avert you from the straight path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have an enemy. Your enemy is the shaitan, the devil. Try to win your fight against the shaitan. Win your fight against yourself. Fight the fight against arrogance, against show off, against ignorance, against laziness, against selfishness. Let's win this war first, because without winning this war, we will never be able to win any other war. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Ramadan is the month that we receive another chance to fix our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to start from our own community, from our own masjid. When Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam migrated from Mecca to Medina, the first thing he said, he established the masjid. Established the masjid for the Muslims. To do everything in life is starting from the masjid. Strengthen the masjid is very important. The Prophet also established the brotherhood among the believers. Cooperation, love, support. And he also offered the non-Muslims coexistent peaceful agreement to live in peace with others, alayhi salatu wasalam. And he took it from there and developed a strong country. As Muslims living by millions here in America, we need to start from the masjid and to care about the masjid and to make the masjid strong. And we need also to be real brothers to each other. We need to love one another and to support one another and to cooperate with one another. And need to show the others the righteousness of the Muslims in this land. Live with them in peace and be fair to them. Be peaceful with them. Be kind in good manner with them so they will love your deen. And if they did not follow your deen, at least they will not oppose it. So my brothers and sisters, every Ramadan and the first Jumu'ah, we always here in this masjid ask the community to support the annual budget of the masjid. Because this masjid is your masjid. This is the house of Allah, the house of worship. And the only source of financial support to this masjid is you. There is no country spending money on this masjid. No ministry. No one is supporting except you. You are the one who paid for the roof and the walls and the carpet and this microphone. You are the one who paid for everything in this place. So you own it. And you must keep supporting the masjid to deliver its message. Especially in the month of Ramadan, the expenses is too high. Electricity, water, workers, a lot of things. If you do not support, this masjid will never be opened. And alhamdulillah, every year we need more responsibilities. We have hired security guards to protect you when you pray Taraweeh and when you pray Jumu'ah for your safety, because we are living in very dangerous time. And when we pray, all of us, our face to this direction, and nobody in our back. So it is mandatory upon the administration to find reason to secure the Muslims in their masjid. So alhamdulillah, they hired private security company to protect you while praying. We have babysitting for the kids, for you to be able and your wife to be able to pray the night prayer. So try to the best of your ability when the masjid asks you to support, to give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best sadaqah you give is the sadaqah that you give during Ramadan. Any action of worship during Ramadan, its reward is multiplied. We all knew that. Allah multiplies your reward. You heard in the hadith which is reported in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Abu Huraira, that when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the companions, who is fasting today? Abu Bakr said, I am, O Messenger of Allah, who followed janazah today. Abu Bakr said, I did, O Messenger of Allah, who visited a sick person today. Abu Bakr said, I did, O Messenger of Allah, Who gave charity today?
Abu Bakr said, I did the messenger of Allah. In his fasting day, he is fasting and following janazah and visiting a sick person and donating his money. And absolutely he's praying his prayers and offering the tarawih prayer.
Because he wants to make his fasting day a unique day. He wants to target the forgiveness of Allah. And he doesn't want to lose any chance. So it is a chance that a lot of people missed. Wallahi al-azim, a lot of people lived 2 hours before Ramadan and they departed this earth, passed away. They did not get the chance. But we got the chance. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever got the chance of Ramadan and lost it, he doesn't deserve the guidance of Allah. The Prophet said, فَأَبْعَدَهُ اللَّهُ. May Allah lead him astray. How come he gets this chance and lose it? If Allah will not forgive our sins in Ramadan, tell me when. Tell me when. This is the biggest chance. And we need to show Allah Azza wa Jal that we are committed and we are active. When we pray, we pray. When we fast, we fast. A proper fasting. Refrain from haram before halal. And then when we give for the sake of Allah, we show Allah Azza wa Jal that we care about His masjid. Wallahi al-azim, people are jealous of you. When they see how the masjid is big and beautiful and clean, they see the biggest gathering in the state in this, mashallah, 3 stories masjid. May Allah accept it from you, your effort. Those who donated to build this place, may Allah reward them all. And we need to keep supporting the masjid, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, for this masjid to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Muslims and to the non-Muslims. أقول قولي هذا وأسأل الله عز وجل أن يغفر لي ولكم أجمعين وأن يهب المسيئين منا للمحسنين. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تغفر ذنوبنا وأن تطهر قلوبنا وأن تشرح صدورنا وأن تحسن فروجنا. اللهم واختم بالصالحات أعمالنا. اللهم إنا نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العلى أن تتقبل صيامنا. اللهم تقبل قيامنا. اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر. اللهم تقبل توبتنا. اللهم تقبل توبتنا. اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين. اللهم أصلحنا وأزواجنا وأولادنا واجعلنا صالحين مصلحين. اللهم اهدنا ويسر الهدى لنا واهدي أزواجنا وأولادنا واجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم اغفر لنا واغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا ولأصحاب الفضل علينا. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم أن تنجي المستضعفين من المؤمنين في فلسطين. اللهم كن لهم ولا تكن عليهم. يا رب كن معهم ولا تكن ضدهم. يا رب انصرهم على عدوك وعدوهم. اللهم ألف بين قلوب المسلمين في السودان. اللهم أمن السودانيين في أوطانهم. اللهم وارزق اليمن وليبيا وسوريا الاستقرار والأمن والسلامة يا رب العالمين. اللهم وأمن المسلمين في كشمير وفي الهند وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى أن تعيننا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. ونسألك اللهم أن تتقبل منا صالح أعمالنا. اللهم اجعل خير أعمالنا خواتيمها وخير أيامنا يوم لقائك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله. أقم الصلاة.